What is up, everyone? We are back with Green and Ruby. I'm joined today by Andy and Brian, the usual suspects.
Hello, hello.
Hi, guys.
And we are also joined by the Devin Lindsay from the Virginia Y Schwartz community.
Virginia represent.
Riaz had to step out. He has to work early, so we're going to continue to soldier forth so that we can get this done before the holiday. So we're going to jump right into it. Andy, go ahead. It's not a brainstorm, I swear.
Alrighty, you got this Lyran. When this gets reversed, if you have another remnant character and your opponent's level 0 or lower, you can send their character to clock and bottom card of their top card of the clock to waiting room. So, the different zone bomb, always nice. Between this and the Neon, you have two really good level 0 cards to just remove whatever you want on your opponent's field. And then second effect, when this is put into your waiting room from the stage, you can pay one if you do look at up to three cards from the top of your deck. Choose one card from among them, put it into your clock, the rest into your waiting room. And if you do put a card into your clock, you choose a remnant character in your waiting room, add it back to hand. So it's like a weird sort of Ricky effect where you get to choose the card that you're putting into your clock. So I think it's a little bit better than a normal, like,
yeah, it's Salve better than a normal Krista, sense. Yeah.
You get like a little bit of extra mill to help
this is
find
the Alice.
A target that you want.
This is the Alice, mm-hmm. Ricky, from set one.
It's also
except
a bomb,
it's
though.
Also a bomb, which is great.
That's pretty cool, yeah.
These on-death ones, they're worse than the like normal Mayuri Rickies from like Steins Gate or Princess Connect. But they're still good. Like I think I would play this over any of the other clock pluses in the set, actually. It's first deck speed. It helps fill your grave to give it extra selection. You don't have a search Ricky, so like if you have to play a salvage Ricky, you would rather mill extra cards. And it's on waiting room, so it's at the end of your opponent's attacks. So it's not like you even like get punished for like being on reverse. I think it's just a good card.
You can also, if you need to burn the card on your turn searching for something, you can also just overplay it.
Yeah, if your opponent tries to do something cute like deny it, you just play over it and be like, haha, see a level one bitch, and then you just kill him.
Nice mm-hmm. clean cut target too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Then you get the bomb effect twice.
Yeah, if you want to have an extended zero, it's not the worst card to clean cut. Because you can always play over it, like we said, if you don't have any other target. Needing another card on board to be a bomb makes it a worse opening card. But, like, I don't know.
Ooh, that is true. You can, true. Yeah.
I think that you would slam down a, like, clock plus going first anyway, even if it didn't trade with your opponent's character. And you could slam any other zero to turn the effect on, so I think it's okay. I think it's okay. I'm pretty.
You could always just like throw your brainstorm in the back row or something.
500 power bomb, like clock bomb is like pretty sick. Into like, you know, in English, where people will play Adventure Time. That will be a deck you will see. People will play the Wildberry. Mm-hmm. So it just gives you an out to that, which is cool. Also your clock plus, so pretty good one at that. So pretty sick card for the best green card by a considerable margin. It's not close. Let's go look at worse green cards. Next card.
All right, we've got this Emerald. Level 0, your other character in the middle position of your center stage gets 500 power to middle. And it is a Rest 2 Brainstorm for 5 cards that only hits on the two Cinder combo gates.
Card sus.
Very sussy.
It's a Search Brainstorm. Rest 2 Search
There's
Brainstorm.
There's an imposter amongst us.
Is a Rest 2 Search Brainstorm, even if you are playing these Climaxes, worth playing?
And the funny thing is that at this point in the show, she's trying to play friends with the main group, so, and she is part of the bad guy team, so hence why she goes with the two gate Climaxes there.
Dude, Ruby was sus even before Among Us existed.
Yeah, you could say Emerald was sus. She was the imposter.
Yeah, she is the imposter.
Always the imposter.
The green imposter.
I think if you're playing, I don't think the rest too is necessarily like a terrible thing. There's like a good bit of stuff in this set you wouldn't mind just having sit in your back row. But I mean, I guess then though too, it's like
peeking beyond the
veil. One of the best cards to have sit in your back row would be like that Jean combo, and that would work with this brainstorm.
You wouldn't play that in this deck because it's only 8 gate. It's bad guy set.
It's only the Cinder deck.
Well, at least they didn't trait lock it to villain trait.
Peeking beyond the veil.
If you have another card to sit in the back row with this, it seems fine.
There is a decent salvage, self-rest salvage rainstorm, the normal self-rest salvage, and there is a pretty good spammable search that you can play. And I think in almost every deck I have built, I have always slammed like 2 salvage, 1 spammable search. And it's always seemed great in my deck building. Again, like, we haven't touched any cards yet because we haven't gotten our stuff. The set's not out yet. But I think even in the Cinder deck, I would not play this card because I would play the spammable search lineup. I don't think it's bad. I think you guys are right. I think it's just a decent card. But I don't think I would even play it in the Cinder deck.
Well, I like what Brian said, too. It's nice that they didn't trait lock it or anything, right? Like, if you're playing 8-gate and you think that you... Like, if you're playing the Cinder 8-gate deck and you think that, like, you have, like, enough cards in your back row throughout the game to warrant playing this brainstorm, you can. But if you wanted to just play the... You said there's a normal salvage brainstorm that's just rest self. You could always just play that instead.
Yeah, I'm
checking. Or play any combination of them if you really want to.
I'm checking to see if the Cinder back row has, like, a tap effect. I could have swore it did. I might be wrong. Trying to find it. What the hell is it?
Because Rest 2 brainstorms usually aren't as good as the Rest 1. Especially, it can be a little bit harder to use them earlier on in the game, but...
Not as flexible, yeah.
As long as you have...
It does not.
Another card that doesn't mind sitting in the back row. It's usually not too big of a deal, though.
It does work, like, straight away with the other back row to this deck without any issues, which is nice. It's also nice, I just realized this is a search and you're playing 8 door. So, that is nice. Yeah, if you're building this deck, I guess it's something you can consider, but I don't think that extra card is worth the like, sort of on-demand, like, choice. Like, I wanna search, I wanna salvage, I have these options.
Yeah.
Alright, next card. We got Ozpin on play. Look at top 2. Rearrange them. And then when he attacks, if you have one or less other characters, you mill. That card's level 0, goes to back row.
We've never seen this profile before.
I love this card.
It's Shizuru Spawner. Again, Andy says every time we read it that he loves this card. And then he never sleeves it.
It's like both the good cards in No Game, No Life crammed into one card.
Yeah, I think you say
that every time too.
Yeah, you also say that, and then they never see play because I don't think you can play Shizuru Spawner anymore.
Well, you said if you're that hard up for green,
it's probably
You have to play it. You have to play this if you're playing.
I wouldn't feel bad about playing this at all. This is perfectly fine.
If you're playing the Ozpin top end, you have to play this card.
This is the clock condition, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, sick. Even more reason to play it. I like it a lot. I think it's fine. There's nothing wrong with this card. It's not D tier. Plossing level 0 lets you top 2 rearrange.
It is not. She's a responder. It's bad.
Card's extremely
like you get
fine.
A look and make sure you hit.
Oh my god, who cares? What
do you mean who cares?
What if you top 2 and it's just like a 2-2 and a level 3?
Then you pull them to your back row, you play a different level 0, and you spin the Ozpin next turn.
Oh, so you just go minus 1.
What do you mean you're going minus 1? He sits in your back row and you use him next turn. You're not minusing shit.
You have to have one or less other characters. What if you want to attack 3 times the next turn?
I don't know. Maybe you're just not being that aggressive then. Maybe you just play 2 attackers, all right? Maybe you just slow down a little bit.
That's my point. Is like you can't play Shizuru Spawners anymore because the game is too fast.
It's too fast.
Yeah.
I will admit that Ruby is a set that pushes you. It seems like it pushes you to tri-field and be aggressive early.
I mean, Clean Cut does that.
Yeah, Clean Cut does that all by itself, yeah. Alright, whatever. Next card. Devin, go ahead.
Yep. It's the Toaster. Penny Palladina? Palladina? I've never heard the last name before.
Penny
anyway,
P.
Toaster. Anyway, when this card is placed on stage from hand, this card gets 1500 power until end of turn. Climax combo with gold bar. Military weapon. When this card attacks, if military weapon's in your climax area, and you have another remnant character, put the top two cards of your deck into your waiting room. Choose up to one level X or lower remnant character in your waiting room. Return to your hand. X is equal to the total level of cards put into your waiting room by this effect. God, I love smoking cigarettes.
Yeah.
Get that bread out of that toaster. It's burning. It's smoking up the place.
Yep. It's menthols. We're smoking menthols today.
Is she a robot? Is that the joke?
Yeah, she is a robot, yes.
Okay.
She's a robot with a soul implanted.
You got...
Don't worry, it's not a spoiler. They tell you right away.
Toast not.
Okay.
Not.
You have good level zeros in Ruby. So cigarettes is a little better. I think the problem with playing this card is that green sucks.
Ricky Bomb.
Saying green sucks, but this penny's fine. The Lyran's fine.
Don't say Ozpin's fine. Don't play
he's
Ozpin's
fine.
Fine.
He's fine. He's
don't
not great, Ozpin's but he's fine. Fine.
Okay,
perfectly
Andy.
Fine.
Andy.
What?
That's it. There are 10. Hey, so, like, if
we're
you...
We're, like, 3 for 4 right now.
Okay.
We're 3 for 4 right now.
That's 12 green cards if you play 4 of each. That's it. I consider the minimum to play a level 1 combo consistently on your first level 1 turn every time to be between, like, 13 minimum.
That's 16. Your climaxes are green, too.
13 minimum.
Okay.
You're one off.
No. Like, 13, 14, not including climaxes. 15 is where I feel actually comfortable. 15, not including climaxes.
Okay, well, let's talk about the good things this card does. It's
cigarettes.
You don't need a reverse. It's a reverseless cigarettes. So
it's like the most bog standard on attack combo ever.
But it's on bar.
It is on bar,
which makes it better.
Before, has it?
Yes, it has.
It probably has been. Not in English.
Mm.
The Yotsuba combo from Quince, I think.
Yeah, Yotsuba.
GD combo.
Oh, whatever. Everyone loves that card. Everyone plays that card, all right?
Yeah, Yotsuba. Because there's a JC. There's
even
a JC that goes with Yotsuba.
Basically Yotsuba.
Yeah, there's JC in that. That's a reason to do that.
Okay, well, still, plussing level, non-interactive plussing level 1 combo off a gold bar. Gold bar
yeah,
is like the best
fine.
Thing you can have on a level 1 combo, probably, besides, like, standby.
Yes, it's fine. It is a fine combo, but it...
Yeah, it's a...
But green sucks.
It's like Ozpin.
Green sucks. That's
cool.
Yep.
I'm giving it a... I'm literally giving it a C because green is so bad.
Combo's fine.
Just like I tried to build with this combo to see if we could do anything with it. I literally could not fulfill enough green for me to be comfortable, and I scrapped the deck every time. I couldn't do it. That's just where I'm coming from. I don't have anything against this card in general. What I have against is green cards that are not Lyran. Green cards that are not Lyran are pretty whatever. I don't like Ozpin. I don't like Caesar Spawner.
I think you're being a bit of a doomsayer, maybe, but...
I am being a doomsayer, yes. I think...
Let's see what other green cards we have along the way. I think if you wanted to play this combo, right. you probably could, you know?
Okay, all right. We'll look at other cards. Okay, Andy, go ahead.
Like Oobleck.
All right, we got Oobleck.
Field trip,
yep. When your other character's battle opponent gets reversed, you choose one of your characters and give it 1,000 power. What's that card called, Carmen? Is it like Rolling Power?
Rolling Power.
Revenge.
Yeah.
Rolling Power.
Yeah, rolling Power.
Rolling.
And then.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then pay 2, rest them, search your deck.
You know, sidebar. I don't even think rolling is like a real thing. I think we've just invented it over like playing and not having a way to refer to that effect. And we've just called it rolling. So now I guess it's real.
It's rolling power now.
Yeah, we're YouTubers. We have 1,000 subs now, so we get a call.
I guess that's
call
real
the shots.
Now. Okay.
Fact checkers come to us.
All right.
I don't know. I think it's fine. I don't know. The pay 2, rest this to search. I mean, I suppose it's all right. If, it's nice if you have something else good to pair with it, right? Like the earlier we saw the Pyrrha back row that was like an assist that also had it on there.
Mm-hmm.
That was kind of nice as like a little bonus, but on a level zero, I don't think it.
If you have like an open back row slot and you're not doing anything and you desperately need to fix for green, you could put it in your deck and your deck would be bad, but you would have extra green. But
there you have it.
The rolling thousand, I don't know. You,
I'm not really a huge fan of the rolling power.
Yeah, I don't know what that does.
But I guess maybe it does get a bit nutty when you combine it with like the Ruby combo of the trial deck.
Maybe it's just like
everything is giving
power.
Rolling power. Maybe.
But maybe it just steamrolls. I don't know. I don't think it's enough.
Probably not. Probably still too cute.
All right.
Good for budget. Nothing else.
Next, Ryan.
Oh, we've got Chef's Apron Wren. It's a 2500 power counter. It's green. And it has, when you use this card's backup, pay to sack a character, sack counter, and anti-change to waiting room.
There you go, Carmen. There's your 13th green card.
It is a card you could play. It's not the worst. But you can't kiss the cook. It says, please do nothing to the cook.
Yeah. I mean, he has a blend of herbs and vegetables filled with nutrients that are vital to your body's well-being.
Is that mm-hmm. what that is?
It's also green.
Am I the only person here who hasn't watched Groovy?
I think so.
God. Yeah.
Okay. Card's fine.
He has it because of Nora. He has it because of Nora. That's the only reason.
Okay.
Because she is very aggressive.
It is.
Love Nora.
It is just anti-change counter.
It is. Waiting room anti-change counter. It is a sack counter. You can dodge on reverse combos with it if you absolutely have to.
Tell someone's marker rem no. In two lanes.
Next card, we got Uniform Wren. This is another playable green card. During your turn, 500 power for each of the remnant characters. So it's 11-5. On play, you can search for a remnant character. And then when your battle opponent becomes reversed, you can discard two characters, and then you claw kick that character that you reversed that is available cross-turn, but the power is only on your turn. So you will probably only be getting a reverse with this on your turn. So it is an off-finisher that does cantrip from deck, which is cool. But the fact that he is losing power, he loses 500 power for the claw kick to be cross turn, yet gains on turn power. It's a little weird. This card could be a 12k if it was only on your turn claw kick, but it is power balanced very weirdly.
Mm-hmm.
But it does stop your opponent from being able to crash the lane comfortably. So, you know, I guess there's that.
It cantrips, I guess. Yeah, it's
yeah, it's a totally fine card. This is the worst off finisher in the set, I think. By like
probably.
Yeah. Not great. But it is a playable green card.
I mean, yeah, it's fine. It's like a fine off finisher still. Like being the worst out of the good off finishers is like it's still a good card.
Yeah. Okay. Next. Devin, go ahead.
Mm-hmm.
Ozpin fighting off Cinder. If Ozpin, the 00, is in your clock, this card gets minus one level in hand. And when this card is placed on the stage from hand, draw two cards. Choose one card in your hand, put it into your waiting room. CX combo. Card attacks. If Defending the School is in your climax area and you have four or more other remnant characters, this card gets 1,000 power and the following ability until the end of your opponent's next turn. Beginning of your opponent's attack phase, choose one of your opponent's characters, and that character gets minus two soul until end of turn. Next soul in 2022.
I mean, it's got everything a next soul combo wants. It's got a good early play condition. It draws into its own climax. It's off bar. It just sits really small.
Okay. Hear me out, Brian. Draw two, ditch one isn't a good enter effect when your climax combo is already on bar.
Sure. I mean, it's extra insurance to make sure you get into
it. I guess, yeah, because you can play another copy down if your opponent kills it. So this is like an early play Negsoul wall that's like incentivizing you to not keep it on board, but to play another copy. In which case, how do you have the stock to play another copy? There are no stock charging combos or stock charging options in the set at all, actually.
You just attack three times from the beginning of the game.
Which only lets you play one the turn after your opponent kills at least two. So if you tap all the way out to play three, and your opponent kills two and has a climax down and shoves any amount of damage past, you did not heal, and you have to refill your board.
Okay, well, maybe you just don't play three. Maybe you just play two.
Is
that really sounds, that bad?
Sounds even worse.
We just got through talking about how every trigger in yellow is a choice. There's your stock.
Choice bar. Choice. Yeah, that could
problem,
work.
Problem solved. Deck solved. Ruby solved. Stop the set review.
I hate it. I hate everything about it. I would never sleeve it. I hate Negasoul combos. Especially ones that target.
It's probably going to be about the first thing I sleeve up, just so I have an excuse to play the odds pin level zero.
In this set, I don't think it's relevant at all.
I think it's the power.
I do enjoy Negasoul. It's definitely the power.
It's the power.
It's definitely the power. I think you splash yellow in with it, but then again, I feel like I think you really want blue. You really want blue in this deck.
If you want to play a level 2 like bomb, you play the Pyrrha combo that we already saw. Like, the Pyrrha is like actually good, and this is like just bleh. Like, you're going to play down two of this, and you're going to look up, and your opponent is going to be playing Datalive, and they got their dunce cap on, and, like, they're just, like, actually just, like, a complete idiot, and they just slam down two blinkers and then sack them off, and they say, oh, your combo not do nothing no more, and then, like, you cry and you lose, and you say, God damn it, that Datalive got me again, and I would have got away with it, too, if it weren't for the shitty card.
All right. I don't think it's like the meta combo for this set, but
far from.
You could play it, sure.
It's like fine. It's playable.
It does function. It is functional. I will not say it's not functional. I just don't think the function is good enough.
Imagine this against AOT. Can't target anything. Oh no.
Yeah, you just can't target.
But imagine just being able to run four of that Oz pin level zero.
Oh my god.
Just imagine.
imagine just getting shot straight to level one.
The level zero is the best part about this level three.
Oh my god.
I mean, it honestly might be.
Yeah, probably.
And the all right. Zero is not
I think
great.
We're on the same page.
Well, actually.
What? Okay. Go ahead.
Do you think that there's maybe a case to just play the Ozpin early play without the combo? Just, like, play it as an early play?
No! No!
Even meet condition,
no, no,
draw
I
two digits.
No! I don't think so.
Not at all! No! You can't play a 3-2-9-5 that's draw two ditch one that you have to clock for.
It's a free condition.
No, it's not! Free. Not if you have to
that's
clock it! You take
what
a damage!
But you get to incidentally...
Oh my god, you're clocking
zero.
For turn, dude! Just clock him for turn!
Why clock when I could play Blake and heal?
Now...
Well, you could play Blake also. You play the Ozpin, you drop this early play, then you play the Blake, you heal him off.
No, you play the Ozpin, you draw into the Blake you didn't have, and then you play the Blake.
Yeah,
oh
exactly.
My god.
I'm like half joking, but like half serious. Like,
no, your set is not that
you
bad.
You could just play him.
This set is not bad enough to have to do that, Andy.
That's a no game, no life play.
Yeah, Brian and I were thinking
I would
the same
do
thing.
If no game, no life would have that. I'd be pretty happy actually.
Okay. On the same page there.
All right, next card. Back to Andy.
Roy Stallion.
Another ponytail.
Unnamed character until right now. Roy Stallion. That's a cool name. Sounds like a Full Metal Alchemist character.
That's Roy Mustang.
That is Roy Mustang.
They definitely copied that. That's
wait, is Mustang no Stallion? Wait a second. No, that isn't. That is a copy. Rooster Teeth, come on.
Oh, I love them. When this card is placed on stage from your hand, you may pay the cost, which is return two characters from your waiting room back to your deck and shuffle. And then he can side attack without soul penalty this turn. And when he attacks, you choose a character in your opponent's center stage and give it -1,000. So it's kind of like a 1,000 power power pump with some additional upside of being able to just flat out kill something.
Yeah,
not really a huge fan. I like side attacking for free, but
shuffle two backs a lot for that.
Yeah, I can't think of anything that you benefit by shuffling back into your deck, really.
If it was a coin flip, like check top character, it's fine. It's whatever. But nah, it's
doesn't do anything, yeah.
Just kind of dirtles and eats berries. That's about it.
Yeah.
Oh, and snow bunnies.
Snow bunnies, yeah.
That's about it.
Next card, Ryan.
Got Sage Ayana. Level 0. When this card is placed on the stage from your hand, choose up to one of your opponent's characters, put it into their memory, and then put it back. It blinks. Also, when this card is placed on the stage from your hand, choose one of your other remnant characters. That character gets 2k until the end of the turn.
That's like, it's like okay, just okay.
Yeah, if you need the power, it's fine.
If you need the blank, I think if you need the blank and you have like this power pump on a stick with it, I guess that's kind of nice, but
yeah, can't target itself. It can't just swing.
You
don't really need the power
already.
Pump on a stick.
You have the clean cut, yeah.
Yeah, the clean cut already has it covered there.
Yeah, I think it's a one of, if that.
Yeah, if you're in a meta where you desperately need the blink, you play it. The set has it, but it's. I wouldn't play this card just to play it.
Yeah,
it overlaps too much with the gang.
All right, next. Yatsuhashi Daichi. Your hand has 5 or more cards. This card gets plus 2k power. Then it has Encore, where you must pay 1 and sack a character.
Okay.
So wait a second. Pay 1, yes. Sack a character. Can you pay 1 and sack himself?
No, I don't think so, because when he's put into the waiting room, you may pay cost.
Yes,
he's in the waiting room.
You can sack a character that's already reversed.
You can.
But yep. You cannot sack him. But it's just a 3-5. 5 or more cards in hand, 3-5.
It's okay.
It's fine.
I guess you have some synergy with the Lai Ren, but...
Bruh, come on. We were talking earlier how the 4K... Conditionless 4K.
Yeah, it's not good enough yet. Yeah. I don't think this is good enough either. I think this is just, like, weird, like, pack filler garbage card.
Mm-hmm. I mean, in your hypothetical Ruby Wonderland where you are tri-fielding because you have a clean cut, this thing does Encore for 1. It does plus itself back up for 1 by sacking a character that's already reversed.
Sure.
I guess if you're just trying to go, like, max gas, like, from the word go... I guess you make a little bit of a case for it there, Brian. Like maybe if you were turn one, go three attacks, turn two, then go 3 attacks.
You could go like this, clean cut, another card, your clean cut dies, this dies, you pay 1, sack the clean cut, this lives. You shove up the other card, you play another clean cut, because you're still at level 0, because you're a god.
Like, yeah, it's just to push your aggressive advantage at level 0 if you're going for that, I guess.
I guess you could, but I mean, I guess at that point, why not just play the live run? Yeah, you have to clock yourself, but
yeah, that card's
that's
just
fine.
Better.
It's early game anyway.
Yeah, you want to clock yourself? Enough. You want to go to 1? All right, next card, Devin, go ahead.
It is a Bartholomew Oobleck. 1-0 on play. Pitch a card. When this card's placed on stage from hand, you may pay the cost. If you do, choose one remnant character in your clock, return it to your hand, and put the top card of your deck into your clock. And when it becomes reversed, if your battle opponent's cost 0 or lower, you may put this card or put the top card of your opponent's clock into their waiting room. If you do, put that character into your opponent's clock. It is a clock bomb.
Clock bomb, clock filter.
Like nice. A worse version of the Sakura bomb.
Yeah.
The
fact that he can't grab events out of your clock is kind of unfortunate.
Yeah, that's pretty cringe.
Yeah, that part's cringe.
Clock bombs suck right now. Unless you play against slime.
Hey, well, you're talking earlier, Carmen, about, like, let's get enough playable green in a deck. He's playable.
He is playable, but I don't think it's a good meta pick. I would not play a Clock Bomb right now, but the card itself is just okay. Yeah, I think the card itself is fine. In the current meta, you guys are right. It's like a C-.
Borderline unplayable right now, but I mean, it's not the worst card you could put.
Depends on your meta, right? If you play against nothing but, like, fucking slime and you're trying to fix green, you can play this card.
Sure.
Like, there's also a blue bottom deck bomb. There's a red bomb. Like, you have options. I want to play a bomb. So, all right. Back to Andy.
Alrighty. We got Flint Coal. During your turn, if you have another remnant character, he gets 15 hundo, so it's 6k. And when you play him from stage to hand, you can pay one if you do search your deck for another copy of him and put it on the field.
Pay one plus to for just himself.
Yeah, you can't. You can only get up to one with this. He has to come in from hand to get that trigger. Right. So the one you have summoned from deck will not be able to get you a third, but pay one plus.
If you desperately need a pay one plus, it's fine, but I think the card's pretty bad.
I think I'd rather just play apples.
Probably.
Yep. It's
apples
funny, though,
is
because...
more slots, though.
Apples is, I guess you're right. Yeah, this is less slots than apples.
Less slots.
Maybe.
Go ahead, Devin. Yeah.
Now, if only it did come from deck, it would be hella flavorful, too, because this dude splits off into four different versions of himself to do an attack.
That is funny.
Like his people, yeah.
He hits people with sound waves. He's part of the same team as Neon Cat.
As Neon Cat.
All right. Okay.
Jazzy.
Next
team
card.
Team Funky.
Ryan, right?
Yeah,
Ryan got...
All right, we've got 1-1, Coco Adele. If the character facing this card is cost 0 or lower, this card becomes level 2 8k power. And at the beginning of your encore step, if you don't have another rested character, you can pay one and rest this card.
This is the best standby card to play when no one else is playing standby. And the second anyone else is playing standby, this card is garbage. And other people are playing standby, so this card is garbage. But
it's a meta pick.
In a vacuum, I will give it a C because it is fine. I have played this card in Symphogear. It is fine when you play against non-standby people. Yeah, that's about it. Next. We have GG Extend Hand, Emerald and Mercury, Infiltrating Beacon Academy. It's a fucking 6k hand encore. Card's unplayable.
That's like it's a 2017 Weiss profile.
Best part about this card is the art. You get to hit
big hand.
Big
get
hand.
To hit people with the Extend Hand GG
big
emoji.
Hand.
Discord. Extend Hand. When your opponent is in a losing situation, just pass them a copy of this card. Extend Hand. Super BM. Alright, next.
Oh, sick.
Devin, go ahead.
Alright. Emerald Scouted. During your turn, this card gets 1500 power for each of your other remnant characters. When your climax with door and its trigger icon is placed into your climax area, look at the top card of your deck, put it on top of your deck, or into your waiting room, and this card gets following ability until the end of the turn auto. When this card's battle opponent becomes reversed, you may choose one remnant character in your waiting room, put it into your stock. Well, that's a plus stock.
Yeah, there's your stock for Ozpin. You gotta play Gate, though.
So, you know how we talked about that one time about how the Bushiroad makes cards by, like, having the dolphins, like, kick the balls into the bucket, and eventually a card comes out. The second effect on this card reads like the dolphin bucket.
It does, honestly.
Like, it's literally just, like, a run-on sentence where, like, someone could not decide whether they wanted to stop or just, like, oh, you're gonna trigger a climax, and you're gonna surveil, and then you're gonna get a stalk, and then you're gonna do this, and, like, they were like, you need to stop writing. And they're like, okay, we're gonna stop it there. And the card just doesn't make any sense. It's like a 12-5, where when you play a climax of a 13-5, where it plays for free... Where the only thing you get over, like, playing an Adachi versus playing this to clear an early play is, like, It plays for nothing, a surveil?
It pays for itself, and you get the surveil, but only if you trigger a gate climb, or when you play a gate climb.
You have to be not playing enough green to play a green level 2?
Okay. Oh my god, are you that stupid?
What are you talking about? What do you mean it's obvious? Yes, it's going for the Cinder deck. Yes, I get it.
Yes, you play it in the Cinder deck with your Emerald Brainstorm that also only works with doors.
Yes.
And then you play 8 door.
Yes.
And this is other green card in your deck.
Sure. You got it.
But in like a vacuum though, or like I don't know, like
it does. Yes. You're right. Is it
just a level 3? It's like a level 3 killer with additional upside.
In that deck,
if you're playing the Ruby Door Climax.
In that deck.
Or if you're playing Cinder 8 Door, you just have this additional effect on it.
If you are playing Cinder 8 Door, this is like almost as good as the Rider, right? Fate, right? Similar to the Rider. But only in that deck, and only if you have a climax down, which makes it a lot worse.
What about if you're playing Ruby Door? This can work with Ruby's Door.
It could be playing. Yes, you could be playing.
Which also does have a level 2 combo if you're playing red, blue, green.
Oh, jeez.
That is 3 colors.
Yeah.
At 2.
I know.
I don't like
red
that.
Red, Ruby, dude.
But it's still worse. Like, you see what I'm saying, right? It's like. The Rider is a good situational tech card. This is like a card that's worse than the Rider by like a considerable margin that's trying to do the same thing, so it's bad.
Yeah, it's a little more like it funnels you into like a more specific build. It's a lot less flexible, but I think it's fine if you're playing a Gate Climax and have enough green.
Like, sure, yeah. In that deck, this card is like okay. Like, because that deck never wins board at 1, as we'll see when we get to red. It's literally impossible for you to win board at 1 with the Cinder combo, if you're playing the Cinder combo. Like, if you're playing the Cinder combo, you definitely play this, because you have to make up some amount of lost ground. You can't let your opponent just plus on board forever, because your combo with Climax gets to 6k. It's like just a fucking joke. But you probably do have to play this to, like, kill literally anything. When you get to 2, because your only hope is recurring Climax combo. So it's probably fine. I mean,
it's probably good meant to.
Alright. Next card. Is this me again? Or no? Devin read that one, so it's back to Andy.
I'm going to be honest, I almost misread that last name there. Rhys Chloris. When this card's placed on stage from your hand, choose one of your opponent's center stage characters. And that character gets minus a K. When this gets reversed, if the level of this card's battle opponent is higher than their level, it's a clock, a dachi.
Well, it's not an adachi, it's 2-1.
Whatever.
This card's really weird, too. That first effect is just so out of place.
Yeah, it's a dolphin card.
Oh!
It's a dolphin card.
The idea balls. But I don't know. I mean, if you're playing this card specifically just to like, it's just meant to clear their early play, and then I mean, you're crashing it in, it's gonna die anyway. You know, the first effect on there, the minus 1,000 power, that's just gravy. But
yeah.
when you compare it to other cards that have been printed,
bad
like
gravy, fucking
like the
sucks.
Like the Adachis with like mob. Like, stuff that, like, refunds your stock and whatever.
That gravy is not reduced. There's not enough cornstarch in the gravy. It's not thick enough. Bad gravy.
Sad, because this character was actually pretty dope when she was revealed. Like, she rides around on a skateboard that splits apart and turns into twin pistols.
All with guns.
Wow. This show does sound like something I'd be into for no particular reason. but I can't watch CG. It makes my eyes burn.
You'll get used to it. You'll get used to it.
Oh my God.
It does get slightly better as it goes on.
First few episodes are maybe a little bit like weird if you're not used to that style of animation, but you get used to it.
Sad thing, you're watching it on Netflix. It's 2-hour long episodes.
Wait, what?
No, because
just split the first season.
They just put the whole parts together as like movie length.
Yeah, So mm-hmm. yeah, so the first season, second season, which is how I first saw it on Netflix, they had them all combined in a movie length pieces. Yeah,
that sounds weirdly easily digestible compared to episodes.
I mean, in season one where I watched it, the episode they were like 6 to 10 minute episodes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, on YouTube.
Yep. Yep, and now they're up to like 18, 20 minute episodes.
Yeah, they do full length episodes in the more recent seasons.
Yeah, it's a real anime now.
Sure. Go ahead, Brian. Read this card.
We've got Cardin Winchester. He's a 2/1, and he gets 2,500 power for each character in your opponent's backstage, all the way up to 10/5. At the beginning of your encore step, if you don't have another rested character, you can pay one and rest him.
Wow. It's like the worst Liz 2/2 ever.
Yep, it's don't like it.
I do not like it. It's a plus. It's
a pretty flavorful card, I guess.
He just keeps coming back.
He's kind of like a buff douchebag, and
he just keeps coming
back.
Never
does anything. Yeah.
Racing against these people. Instant flunk.
All right. Last green card. We got Beacon Academy. I assume this is the school that they go to.
It's Hogwarts, yeah.
All right, it's the sword event. It's a 1/1 that goes to memory. You reveal top. As long as it's an event or a remnant, so as long as it is not a climax, you put that card into your hand, and then during your turn, for each copy of this that you have in your memory, you give global 500 to everything. So when it stacks, if you have all four, it's a global 2K. Sword's, like, pretty okay as a memory card.
Yeah, it compresses you, I guess.
There is nothing that works off this card. This is just raw sword.
Okay, there's not.
And there's nothing that bonds to it, and there's nothing that works with it. So as raw sword, I don't think raw sword is actually good enough. I think that's actually pretty bad. It's not like a mask, right? It's not selective.
Yeah.
The power, maybe. Maybe it puts you at the right power thresholds for like something to be threatening, but I mean, like, we have to do testing for that. So I think like smoke test, like blind, like you. I don't think blind sword is actually good enough to see play.
Yeah, sword with no support seems kind of meh.
Does anyone have any other opinions? See what I told you, Andy? Green sucks.
There are probably enough green cards to
honestly. Okay, so like let's look at Beacon Academy here, right? Like it's good enough, right? Like it's fine. Like, no, I don't think it's like good enough just to like sleeve up, like unless you are like pushed into it for some reason or another. But like, if you like, I wouldn't go into green to play this card. But if I was
trying to
stretch to like find enough green fix, this card would fit the bill.
I'm talking about like splashable green to play Penny as your level one.
This is probably splashable.
You got to play 4 Ricky. You're playing 4 Penny. You probably got to play like 2 to 3 Ozpin minimum. You probably have to play the anti-change counter as your defensive counter. You probably have to play one of the uniform rem as your off finisher, and it's a worse one. And then as your auxiliary level 1, if you have the slots, you play like this Oobleck that's bad into the meta. So like that was like my thing when I said like playing the Penny is hard. It's hard to play the Penny.
Could you just, like, commit to this package and just play, like, 3 to 4 beacons?
I guess, but that seems bad. It doesn't seem like it does.
I mean, it definitely doesn't feel great. But this is a playable, serviceable card that is green.
I have a really, like, decent level 1 combo package already, so why would I stretch to play green to play vanilla cigarettes? That's, like,
green.
My thing.
What do you mean?
Because you need green to do what?
To play the level 1.
Well, but why would I stretch to play the level 1 when I have another good level 1 combo package? That was my retort.
It's also in your colors that you're wanting.
You would really need like a really nice payoff card somewhere in green, or just like really want the bar trigger.
If the money counter was in green,
isn't really an incentive.
I would
be
all
honest,
for it, yeah.
Unless you're trying to play like that canned 8-bar Ozpin deck with Penny.
Seems kind of sus.
You're probably not going into green. Like, I mean, if you're really a fan of that cigarettes combo on bar and you just need like enough green to make it work, you probably could scrounge up enough green.
You can. It just doesn't feel good.
Probably not the optimal meta build.
Mm-hmm.
But who knows? Like, again, we don't have the cards in our hand yet, so somebody might figure something out.
Yeah, maybe they'll misprint this card. Maybe it'll give, like, 1,000 power.
Yeah, who knows?
Or maybe you won't have to discard.
Bushiroad.
All right. We will see you guys in red.